Hey everybody, it's Public Aggressive 1000, and in the last episode, can I talk any faster during these intros? In the last episode we did, the rest of the Vasebreaker puzzles, and we also did a pogo party. In this episode we're gonna do the survival levels, and I'm so happy because I love the survival levels. Basically the gimmick of these survival levels, is... it's a really, really, really long level, but you're going to have the chance to go back and pick new plants after every couple of waves. After every wave. So what am I going to do here? What am I going to do? Okay, I'm going to get those. What do I want to do here? Now, unfortunately, the first couple of days of this are a bit underwhelming. Because you don't really have, like, there's going to be harder versions of survival later that are 10 flags instead of just 5, and there's going to be a lot more zombies, so they're a lot longer and they're a lot more fun, but we don't have any of that stuff yet, so it's kind of going to be a little bit lame sauce, but oh well. Anyway. I didn't plan on what I was going to do for this level. Man, it's kind of difficult. It's difficult to say. I think. I do not know. How about let's just go with a simple old Torchwood strategy. That's good. Look at Spikeweed and Tallnuts. I'm probably not going to have time to plant all this stuff, but that's fine. Alright. So yeah, it's 5 flags, but after every single flag, you're gonna get the chance to go back and pick more plants. So it's pretty freaking cool. It's also a good excuse for them to throw really, really big, large amounts of zombies. Like, immense amounts. I'm serious. But yeah, so, yeah. There's not really going to be much to talk about, though. I mean, apart from, like, going step by step, okay, this is what I'm doing, and this is why I'm doing it, and this is exactly how I'm doing it. Oh, it's so interesting. But whatever. Yeah, it's a good time. Let's get one more sun and make a twin sunflower ASAP. There we go. Plants that take a long time to charge, like twin sunflowers and Gatling peas, any upgrade plant usually takes a really long time to charge. So it's best to, you know, make one when you have enough sun to I planted that a bit too far ahead. I don't think it's gonna be a problem, but I'm not happy with how far ahead I placed that because it's gonna give me a little less time before the next zombie comes out, I think. Perhaps, I'm not entirely sure. But I think we can start placing down the actual artillery now. We got two guys coming. We got two guys going in hard. Strap in. Oh well, I can use a potato mine on you. I don't feel too bad about that. Talking like a zombie, blah 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 blah. All flat and dead. I don't like how that's. I don't like that. That cone head. No sir, I do not. I'm just gonna put double repeater. That's what they're called. Yeah. There's something I wanted to talk about. It's hard to talk about something without being like, hey, you know, I don't know if you care, but I did this that's totally unrelated to the game I'm playing. You know, it's stupid. It's hard to... you can't really segue into a topic you want to talk about unless the topic has something to do, unless you can segue into it somehow. Then it's like, oh, we'll go nuts. But otherwise, it's like... holy cow, those guys move so slow. Otherwise, it's like... I'm playing Plants vs. Zombies. Oh, by the way, I was doing a Pokemon Y Nuzlocke. You know, that's kind of what I wanted to talk about. But see how stupid that was. And I mean, sure, I probably could have picked a million less awkward ways of bringing that up. But yeah, I'm doing a Pokemon Y Nuzlocke, and it's pretty fun actually. I'm doing it without the EXP share, so my Pokemon team isn't like crazy overleveled. And you'd be surprised at how hard that game gets if you don't use the EXP share. Like, I've got all my Pokemon, like... I've played with all of my Pokemon in the Pokemon ME. So they're all at 2 hearts, at least. And it's still, they're, like, with even with the boosted EXP, we're just barely keeping up with the levels of enemy Pokemon with that boosted EXP, as since we're not using the EXP share. We're gonna get a huge wave soon here. There goes my entire head, it's gone. See, I actually had enough money. Off screen, I actually sold my left-facing Spikeweed. I know, oh, you sold your left-facing Spikeweed, that's like taboo or something, but... I mean, honestly, you know, this is an LP file. I'm not going for 100% here, and I'm certainly not going for a full Zen garden of left-facing plants. That's ridiculous. If I'm going to do that, it's going to be on my own time, on my own file. Okay, this was pretty lame sauce. That was a pretty lame sauce wave. I am disappointed. Now, we have pole vault zombies. Big frickin' deal. Let's get some those. Let's get some those. Those. That, and that. That'll do. We don't have anything for emergencies, but... Well, yeah. That's not good, actually. It would have done me well to include some foresight in my planting strategy here. For I have taken absolutely no precautions in the event of an emergency. I'm talking like a zombie, blah, 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 blah. You're so dead. Dead plus dead. Alright, we got last twin sunflower. There you go. Now we got good. We got good. We have good. We have good what? I don't know. We have good. Start planting those Torchwoods, I guess. I'll plant Torchwoods on the rows that have repeaters. Instead of Gatling peas first, just to bolster them to the strength of the Gatling peas. Yeah, a guy in my comment section said, it's like, well, why would, basically said, like, why would you use Gatling peas when you could just use 2 repeaters? You know, it recharges faster and it actually costs less, and it's like, yeah, you're right. But the thing about that is, planting, I'll just keep planting Torchwoods, I guess. The thing about that is, well, the Gatling peas only take up 1 space. Like, and when you get into the intense amounts of ordnance that you get in some of these later survival levels, you know, where you want to have, like, 16 peas firing on every single zombie that comes out in a row, you know, how are you going to do that? You could plant 4 repeat. Wait, hold on. You could plant 8 repeaters, but that would take up literally all the space on your lawn. If you upgraded them to Gatling peas, though, it would only take up 4 rows, and you would still have room for defensive plants. So that's basically my thought process there, and I think most people's thought process. That's the way Gatling peas are still somewhat superior to regular pea shooters, to regular repeaters. Even if, you know, they might not be exactly cost-effective in these later levels, it's sometimes necessary to pack as much stuff as you can into as little of a space as possible. La-dee-da-dee-da. And now, unfortunately, as you saw, we're killing the zombies pretty fast now. So, it's gonna be... I don't need Torchwoods. I'm gonna need to take those... I wonder how long I can survive with a row of marigolds, where I was planning on planting a second row of Gatling peas, because I like the ridiculosity of this idea. You know what I was thinking of doing? Because I'm putting DKC2 on hold officially until I can figure out a comfortable way to record it. Because I mentioned in that last episode, but I didn't really finish my thought. I said that ZSNES has this thing where it somehow knows, like, how to fuse the inputs on my control stick and on my not control stick and on the D-pad. It somehow knows how to fuse them into, like, 1 big input, so that at any time I feel uncomfortable with one control scheme, I can switch to the other one, no problem. What I didn't say in that episode was that none of the other emulators I can find have been able to do that. which is a problem for me. Because I'm really, really, really prissy when it comes to my controllers. Also, SNES 9X had this like weird audio crackling that I couldn't get away because I had to use an earlier version because for some reason, version like 1.50 and later straight up wouldn't open on my laptop. So I don't know what to tell you, man. Man, those guys take a lot of hits. I should have been planting those guys a long time ago. Well, it's not really a big deal. I will plant some plants. Wow, that was probably my worst. That was probably my best work yet, I think. Oh, right. This is the huge wave, not more zombies approaching. It's like, oh man, how many plants can I plant before they end the round on me? It's like a lot more than you think you can, because the round isn't over yet. Please let me plant another marigold before the round's over. It's gonna be close. Thank you. Okay. And plant one more of those. There. Now, from now on out, pretty much all my sun is gonna be spent upgrading what I already have. So let's bring the repeaters in those in case I need to replace those marigolds with something more useful. Now let's bring those and those, I guess. Sure. Just get some TSPPs. We've got a full row of marigolds making money for us. Just because I like money, and I like seeing it happen. I like seeing it happen on my screen. Yes, 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 I do. Kill the zomb. Kill the zomb with your fire peas. I should have said flame peas, that would have been better. Anyway. Yeah. And, like, I tried Beast Nest, and that was the best one... So far, it didn't have any audio crackling. That's the problem, is, like, ZSNES performs the best on my computer, but I can't really record it. I found out that if I record it in a different resolution, I can get it to look pretty good, but there's this black bar at the bottom still. So I might see if I can get some, like, video editing software that allows me to just, like, crop that out or something. Because if I could do that, then I could probably continue that LP, like, right now. Are you honestly telling me that that fire peas don't pierce through their screen doors? That's ridiculous. That doesn't make an ounce of sense. No, plant your stuff. But yeah, so until I can figure out a comfortable way to record Super Nintendo games, I'm gonna put DKC2 on hold. I know it's gonna be really awkward. I record one episode and then I don't, and then the next one doesn't come out for like a month. It's gonna be like what Nintendo Capri Sun did with Mega Man X, except in my case, you know, I actually uploaded the first video. What I was thinking of doing instead was actually doing a Let's Play of Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Red Rescue Team, the first one on Game Boy Advance. Although I might see if I can actually record it on a DS. Because the DS version has better music, it has higher quality music, and one song in particular sounds a lot better on DS than it does on Game Boy Advance, and I really don't want to miss out on that, because that song is freaking awesome, and everybody who's heard it knows it. Was that the wave? Oh crap, that was the wave, wasn't it? Complete defensive glance, there we go. Now I just need spike weed. TSPPs. I'm gonna leave some space out so that I have room to plant TSPPs if I need them. I don't think I'm gonna need them, but it's always better to be safe rather than better safe than sorry. Let's get those in case I somehow lose any. I don't know, man. It's the exact same stuff I took last time, you know. 2 artillery, 2 hazard, 2 defense, and 2 instance. You really couldn't get a more generic choice for armaments going into a level like this. Oh, you know what I could do, actually? I could actually try planting some repeaters behind, because I don't need any more sun, really. Not a whole lot. Yeah, I'm gonna start slowly replacing my Gatling, my twin sunflowers with repeaters, probably. Instead of my marigolds, because I don't need any more sun, and I don't want to be stocking up sun at an inordinately huge speed. Because that would just be dumb BA. Yeah, now we've got 8 peas firing on that one row, and that row is not going to be having a good time. I shouldn't have committed to planting Gatling peas. Oh, hello, Disco Dan. Or whatever the hell your name is. Who cares? Not me. Yeah, I really shouldn't have committed to putting Gatling peas on those rows, because I'm not going to be able to get enough sun to plant them when I'm replacing my twin sunflowers with them. I would need so much frickin' sun to do that reliably. This is the last part of the level, actually. We're up to 16 minutes. I wonder if I could do the night one, too. I better not. Recharge fast, get you to the end. Da da da, da 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 da. It's good. It's good. Dumb. Anyway. Yeah, this is the final wave. Get some more toilet paper. Enjoy your, like, really... Yeah. The survival levels are not hard. At least not the first 5 ones. They get harder later, but the first ones are not hard at all. Well, I'm just tearing through these guys. But yeah, I was thinking of doing a Pokemon Mystery Dungeon LP. If you're interested, I guess you could let me know in the comments or something. Or if you really want me to do DKC2, I guess that'd be cool too. I mean, I'm sure it's not that complicated trying to figure out how I can record SNES, but... Well. I might also play some NES games, like Mega Man or something. Anyway. Is that the end of this episode? It's kind of anticlimactic to just do, like... I mean, it's only 17 minutes I'm at now, but... Yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. I'll see you next time when we do Survival Night. See ya!